The Miami Dolphins had just one representative in this year's version of the NFL Top 100 Players list. Can any Dolphins make the cut in 2022? The NFL has slowly but surely been releasing the 2021 version of its Top 100 Players list, and as usual there are plenty of surprises and snubs. Your Miami Dolphins have just one representative this year, but the list is an interesting one nonetheless. The Super Bowl champion Tampa Bay Buccaneers have the most players on the list of any team in the league with 8 total, with Tom Brady of course leading the way. The Jaguars came dangerously close to not having any players on the list but were saved by running back James Robinson, who came in at number 100. Plenty of players dropped after underwhelming 2020 seasons, including Michael Thomas, who fell all the way from 5th overall to 72nd. The top 10 is predictably littered with quarterbacks, but there are some newcomers on the list, including last year's rookie phenom Justin Herbert, who earned himself an impressive ranking of 56th. Patrick Mahomes, Lamar Jackson, Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers, and Josh Allen will all appear in the league's top 10, meaning that second-tier guys like Russell Wilson have dropped 10-plus spots to make room for those ascending to the top. After making 0 appearances on last year's list, the Miami Dolphins were represented by Xavien Howard, who came in ranked at a very respectable 17th this season. But for a team that won double-digit games last season and have high aspirations for the one coming up, the single player showing is pathetic, and probably wrong. There are a couple of guys that you could make a serious argument for. But there is always next year, and Miami has a real chance of adding to their total number of players that appear on the list in 2022. So which Dolphins players have the best chance of having a solid upcoming season and making their case for a spot on the NFL Top 100 list next year? Here are 3 possible candidates. NFL Top 100 list candidate, 1. Mike Gesicki. One could argue that Mike Gesicki deserved to be on the NFL Top 100 list this season. If you compare his statistics with those of TJ Hawkinson, who made the list at number 93, then Gesicki looks like a downright snub. Gesicki has been through a rough first 3 years in Miami. He has caught passes from 6 different starting quarterbacks, and has still managed to consistently improve as his career has progressed. He enjoyed something of a breakout season in 2020 despite another quarterback carousel, and will look to build on his progress in what should be his first year catching passes from just one guy. If he is able to build on his numbers and solidify himself as a top 5-8 tight end in the league, then there is little doubt that Gesicki will be on the top 100 list next year. So why did Hawkinson deserve consideration over Gesicki for the 2021 version of the list? The rankings are voted on by the players, so that could certainly be a factor. But as far as the statistics go, there is a serious argument to be made. Hawkinson had 14 more catches and 20 more yards than Gesicki, but he was working with 16 extra targets and a full extra game of action. The two had identical touchdown numbers, 6, but Gesicki had the edge in almost every other remaining category, including yards per game, yards per target, and drop percentage. The top 100 lists do not have a limited number of players per position, so Gesicki making the list doesn't necessarily remove Hawkinson, but the latter has very comparable numbers. There are guys like Jarvis Landry, number 94, Cole Beasley, number 96, and James Robinson, number 100, who could be displaced by Gesicki next year as well. NFL Top 100 List Candidate, 2, Tua Tagovailoa. Much of both the short-term and long-term successes of the Miami Dolphins depends on the development of quarterback Tua Tagovailoa. If he is able to live up to the billing of being a top 5 pick, then Miami will prosper. 2021 will be his first full season as the starter after a tumultuous season in and out of the lineup as a rookie, but he'd have to make quite a statement in his second season if he wants to make an argument for the NFL's top 100 in 2022. The top 100 list in 2021 featured the usual suspects near the top of the list when it came to quarterbacks. Tagovailoa won't be surpassing guys like Patrick Mahomes or Lamar Jackson on the list anytime soon, but the QBs that ranked in the bottom 50 could be susceptible to being replaced. Justin Herbert, number 56, and Baker Mayfield, number 71, have made enough of a statement early in their careers to be worthy of a spot, but they could be an underwhelming season from being moved down or out. Interestingly enough, the lowest-ranked QB on the list is former Miami Dolphins quarterback Ryan Tannehill, number 83. If Tagovailoa wishes to make the list in 2022, it will be Tannehill that he'll need to overtake. The veteran has had outstanding seasons with the Titans over the last 2 years and has a slew of weapons to throw to, but he can absolutely be passed if Tagovailoa is able to show out this coming season. Stay tuned. NFL Top 100 List Candidate, 3, Emmanuel Ogbah. Should the Miami Dolphins defense continue their upward trajectory, then there will be at least a couple of members of the unit that are deserving of a spot on the 2022 list. Barring a jarring regression, Xavien Howard should make another appearance next season. But who will join him? There are plenty of young pieces on Brian Flores' defense that have the potential to be high-quality players in the future, many of whom would have to put together multiple solid years to be considered for the list. So who has already had top 100 worthy seasons who could make an appearance on the next list by having a monster year in 2021? One of the most productive players on the Dolphins' defense last season was Emmanuel Ogbah. In his first season with Miami, the fifth-year defensive end accumulated the second most tackles of his career with 42 combined, but it was his other numbers that stood out. He led the team in both total sacks, 9, and QB hits, 21, and contributed to the Dolphins being the league leader in takeaways with 3 forced fumble and 1 fumble recovery. When he doesn't hit the quarterback, he can still be effective in the passing game, as he was one of 6 defensive ends with 5 or more pass deflections. Ogbah may be expected to shoulder an even heavier load in 2021, which could give him a chance at even higher numbers this season. If he is able to duplicate last year's efficiency on more reps, then Ogbah will have a valid argument for making the NFL's top 100 list in 2022.